I received this question the other day, and he's trying to save some data from his Excel files to a text file, and he has 20 folders named 1, 2, 3 to 20, and each of these folders has a particular type of text. And what with the macro code that he was using, all the data was writing to the first text file. And so I'm going to show how you can write it to individual files. What I did initially here is I have an Excel file, and with the heading rows in the first one, and the folder is A, the file name is 123, and the value that's going to be copied into each of these files is what's in the C column here. And so here's my code. And so I say sub copy to text, and then I declare file name is string, folder is string, file is string. He wanted to go to 20, but I'm just going from X2 to 4 because, for an example's sake here, I'm saying the folder is the active sheet X1, so that would be the folder, would be the A here. And the file name would be the one here, so that would be in the second column. And the value that we want copied to that is in the C column here, which is X3. And address, I've created a folder on my desktop. And so what I've done is when you open that, so I've got the folder open now, and what I've done here is to get the address, I've clicked onto the address bar here, and I've copied this, and then of course I've put a backslash to end that. Okay, so now let's go back to my my code here. And so so that's my address that I've copied, quotation marks in front of it, backslash and quotation marks at the end of what you've copied. And so my file name equals file name, which is the address up which we've defined, and the folder, which we've defined as the value from X1, and the file name is values from the value from X2, and then I'm going and then making it .txt so that it knows that what it's looking for a text file. And then what I say is open file name, which we've defined here for output as number one, and then write to number one, the value which we've defined up here as active cell number 3, value, and then I say close number one, and then next X. So let me just show you that these files are empty. So let's go in the A folder, and we go into number one, and it's got nothing in it, and save. And then we go into number two, and I'll just delete this because I've run it again. I've run it previously, obviously. And we're going to close it and save it. And then the three file will have values in it because I ran it before. And so we'll delete and we're going to save that. Okay, so now when I run my code, so I'm just going to run this here. And so now if we go back to our folder and into the A, we should have a value in one. Then we have, if you look at my Excel sheet, so the value is what I have in the C. And so that's in the file named one and in the folder A. And so now I open up my other one. I open up two, and the same thing. It is it's from the second. It's the second line that we have there, and so it's going through it exactly as I'd planned. It's going to folder A. It's going to file number one, and it's putting this value in. It's going to folder A, and it's going to file number two, and it's putting this value in. And then of course it's going to go to folder A again, and go to file number three and enter this value. Now, you could continue this down so that if you have a B folder, you could have file names 1, 2, 3, 4 and keep doing until you get to 22, which was his initial plan. So that's how you copy values from Excel into text files. Please subscribe.